to earth again.
It's true. You will always hear me call. Sweet, sweet, sweet sound.
Love a spot in my house where no
good morning. Thank you for joining us for our first annual Stand Up for Arts Education event. I'm Jeremiah Jacks, and I serve on the California Music Educators Association State Council, and I'm a music teacher for the Loomis Union School District. Each of our educators' associations have been working hard over the years with our individual advocacy efforts. This year, we have come together to stand up for all of our children's rights to a quality education in the arts. Over the years, we have, through our advocacy efforts, established language in our Ed Code that requires equal access to dance, music, visual arts, and theater. We have worked with state leaders to develop our new framework for the arts. We have begun to build a presence at the Capitol and a relationship with our state legislators and assembly members. Now, more than ever, we must support our children's education in the arts. Now, more than ever, our kids need everything an education in the arts provides them. Now, more than ever, we must be vigilant over the way our schools return our students to the classroom and be sure the arts are among the priority of the administrators and trustees. To speak more about the importance of our advocacy efforts, we are ecstatic to be joined by the actress and singer, Kristen Bell. Kristen Bell has been involved in the arts from childhood. Over the years, she has enjoyed numerous roles that have allowed her to showcase her talent as both an actress and a vocalist. She attended the prestigious Tisch School of the Arts and has spent time on Broadway. Ms. Bell has received numerous nominations and awards, including the Saturn Award, the EDA Female Focus Award, BTVA People's Choice Voice Acting Award 2 times, People's Choice for Favorite Comedy Star, as well as Favorite Actress in a New TV Series, and has received a star on the Walk of Fame, among many other awards. Your family has probably, like my own, been very influenced by Ms. Bell's vocal talent. Our 6-year-old, who has Down syndrome and loves music and dancing, has 4 years now found the greatest joy and shared that great joy with all of us as she sings and dances along with the beautiful voice of Kristen Bell as she sings every song from Frozen. Thank you, Kristen Bell, for brightening our world with your talent in the arts. And now, Kristen Bell.
Hi everyone, I'm Kristen Bell and I wanted to take a minute to say hi and also thank you. Thank you for carrying the albatross of advocating for arts education. I call it an albatross because convincing others that the arts matter is a unique beast to tackle. And this is because it's a paradox to talk about the arts, because artistic expression is actually beyond words. Because art is what takes over when words aren't enough. So when you're trying to get others to see the value of arts education, essentially you're attempting to explain the inexplicable. And that can be hard. But I am so appreciative to all of you who do it because the cause is so important. We need it now, even more than our brains can acknowledge on a conscious level. You know, because in a structured classroom, art provides freedom. In an isolated social media culture, art provides empathy. And in a black and white world, art provides color. You know, there was a study done at University of Otago in New Zealand, 2 American researchers. They analyzed surveys from over 650 young adults who had filled out daily online diaries for 13 days. And among other things, the questions that they would ask were how much time they'd spent in creative endeavors each day. and about their well-being, the levels of positive and negative emotion, and specifically what researchers were calling flourishing, an overall sense of meaning and purpose, engagement, social connection in their lives. Results showed that the people who were engaged in more creative activities on one day reported increased positive emotion and flourishing the next day. The researcher actually stated, "Research often yields complex, murky, or weak findings, but these patterns were strong and straightforward. Doing creative things today predicts improvements in well-being tomorrow." Full stop. And as we all know, it's a domino effect. The happier you are individually, the more you're willing to spread love to others. You're more willing to see outside your perspective, lend a helping hand to a neighbor. And I think it's dramatically clear that societally we have been lacking in our generosity of spirit lately. Art is an anecdote. It is a key connection. So therefore, arts education is a need, not a want. So when you're on your mission, I want you to see it as just that. Not something you want, not something you think would be helpful. No, it is and will always be a collective need. I am so grateful to all of you. You are knights in protecting this precious gift. And for all of your hard work and your reluctance to lay down your sword, I thank you.
Thank you so much, Kristen Bell, for those encouraging words. We do indeed, now more than ever, need the arts. We are very pleased to be joined by Assemblymember Patrick O'Donnell. Assemblymember O'Donnell has over 20 years' experience as an educator and has been a strong supporter of special education and the creative arts. Assemblymember O'Donnell has worked hard to expand educational opportunities for students for generations to come, including vocational training. Assemblymember O'Donnell has also done a lot to better the environment through increased funding for local projects in his community. Because of O'Donnell, the water and beaches around Los Angeles are cleaner and wildlife is more strongly protected. Prior to being elected to the State Assembly, Assemblymember O'Donnell served as a Long Beach City Council member. Born in Long Beach, he graduated from California State University Long Beach with a degree in history and a master's degree in public administration. He lives in the Los Altos neighborhood with his wife and their two daughters. Please welcome Assemblymember Patrick O'Donnell.
Hi, this is Assemblymember Patrick O'Donnell with you today, celebrating with you the Stand Up for Arts Day. Arts are very important in our schools, very important outside of our schools. I am the chair of the Assembly Education Committee. I'm a teacher. I'm the parent of two kids that have been online for too long that have missed art. But I just want to thank the organizations that are very involved in happening today. The California Educational Theater Association, for sure. The California Arts Education Association. The California Dance Education Association. And the California Music Educators Association. For all they're doing today, but really year-round, to advocate for arts and education. Listen, as a classroom teacher, I know how important it is to infuse art into your content delivery, the mastery of instruction. It makes it more enjoyable, it makes it more understandable, and also allows students to show their creativity in different ways. So I'm a big fan of the arts. And arts can be music, arts can be visual, arts can be tactile, and I imagine arts can be in many forms. So I just want to say how much I personally am appreciative of these organizations for pushing this agenda in our schools. Because the fact of the matter is, if you were not pushing this agenda, nobody else would, okay? Other than those who really know how important it is. But I myself, I'm a big advocate of arts and education, recognize that as organizations like yours, all those organizations that really make sure that the arts have a voice in the state capitol and thus a voice in our classrooms across the state of California. So thank you, and it's Stand Up for Arts Day. Let's do it together.
Hello, my name is Armelin De La O, president of the California Music Educators Association. We are excited to launch the first of many Stand Up for Arts Education Days in our state with our partners from the California Art Education Association, California Dance Education Association, and California Educational Theater Association. We want to thank our Stand Up for Music Coalition partners and our industry partners from NAMM who have been at our side for the past 10 years in Sacramento at our Stand Up for Music Days and join us today standing up for arts education. CMEA's mission is to ensure that all students are provided an equal opportunity to access music and arts learning that is not based on the color of their skin, where they live, the language they speak, or their economic status. CMEA informs and educates local and state legislators, school board members, and administrators so they can make decisions that promote music and arts education for all students. Too many of our students this past year have experienced the loss of the ensemble aspect of their music learning. Many students were unable to experience the joy gained from the process of making music together with their classmates and sharing the learning for a live audience. CMEA's advocacy priorities this year are to safeguard against the eliminating of or restricting of students' access to music and arts classes, for the inclusion of arts education fully and in a safe manner in the reopening process and guidance for in-person and distance learning, and for decision makers to recognize that music and arts support students' social, emotional well-being that they will need now and in the future. Please join us today as we meet and share with our legislators the critical role music and arts education plays in students' lives and learning, and invite them to join us and stand up for arts education. Thank you. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce the Drums of Fire Steel Drum Band from Davidson Middle School in San Rafael, directed by Dana Trio.
Hello, my name is Zuri Hart Porter, and I'm in the sixth grade at Enner Brewer Middle School in Oakland, California. I think that musical education is great because you can learn new notes and get to know your classmates in music class. Adding on, when I play my instrument in school, I feel accomplished and I'm not thinking about anything. If we didn't have music class, I would feel that I would be more stressed out in my other classes and even with my homework. Learning music, I can grow my brain and enhance my creativity, helping me reach full potential, especially if there's something going on at home or if you have depression. It will take your mind off of it and gives you a chance to take a break for a while and get lost in the music. That is the true meaning of music class and why I think musical education is very important.
Hello, my name is Michael Despars and I am the proud president of the California Educational Theater Association. I would like to take a moment to welcome you to the 2021 Stand Up for Arts Education Day. I would also like to recognize the month of March as Theater in Our Schools Month and March 27th as World Theater Day. I am so proud of your continued commitment to theater and arts education. According to the Arts is Essential document endorsed by over 100 arts organizations, including the Educational Theater Association, it is imperative that all students have access to an equitable delivery of arts education that includes dance, media arts, music, theater, and visual arts that supports their educational, social, and emotional well-being, taught by certificated professional arts educators. This is even more true today in the post-COVID world. Arts education is part of what has supported my own students in the classroom. It is where they have found their successes in the midst of this tragedy. It is where they came to find a way to express themselves in a world of isolation. The arts will always be a way we support and regrow our communities both in and out of the classroom. There are some things that I just know to be true. First, artists are resilient and they can and will adapt, and we have seen that. Teachers are resilient and they can and will adapt, and boy, has that been true the last few months. And most importantly, students are resilient and can and will adapt, especially our arts students. I would like to thank my four colleagues that represent the four arts ed orgs, the board of the California Educational Theater Association, and the many theater educators who have provided a safe space, an open door, and an opportunity to thousands of students of theater across California to be supported socially, emotionally, and artistically. Educators can be counted among the many heroes of this pandemic. And now it is my honor to introduce an award-winning clip from Chadwick School's production of Romeo and Juliet.
My name is Emily Cole, and I attend Claremont High School in Claremont, California. In our world, theater means expression. An expression of stress, anxiety, melancholy, loneliness, comedy, dramatics, moments. A place under layers of musty cloth where teenagers, adults, directors all lie in hushed collective focus behind drawn curtains. A place to be a part of something. To be a misfit fitting in. From the girl who has never spoken sewing elaborate ball gowns, to the class clown sobering up in the beams of brilliant golden stage lights, to the genderqueer teen painting the eyelids of 20 squirming actors. In theater, we find expression. No matter if his top college just rejected him, or they're signing the custody papers while the audience applauds, it all falls away when you don tech black. For the theater, hums, buzzes, vibrates. The truest sense of a life in darkness. Theater has always been the single place where I can feel. There's a sense of community in every teacher, student, alumni who shows up every night of the week to put a world together. Painting sets, I can be an artist with my hands. Picking costumes, I can be an artist with my eyes. Preparing props, I can be an artist with my ingenuity. Stress, anxiety, melancholy, loneliness, comedy, dramatics. My moment. My moment to breathe. My moment to think. My moment to create. Expression, no matter the individual, may be seen differently, interpreted differently, valued differently, but the beauty of expression is undeniable. So, what does theater mean to the director blocking each step? To the mother who sewed every costume? To the principal wanting a place for those students under the bleachers? It means to tell their stories. To embrace a life you've never lived and walk in the heels, boots, or tennis shoes handed to you. To me, theater means to express yourself for someone else. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Leah Zell, and I'm the president of the California Art Education Association, which supports visual art educators across the state. I want to welcome you to our 2021 virtual Stand Up for Arts Day. And I want to thank you for your ongoing support of visual and performing arts education in California. I understand that we have a diverse group of people watching today, including students, parents, teachers, administrators, legislators, among others. What I hope we have in common is a belief and a conviction that the arts should be part of every student's education, regardless of where they live or what school they attend. I know from my own experience as a parent and art educator in a number of school districts that student access to arts education can vary greatly depending on where you live and the funding and priorities of your district. In California, a small number of students do get art, music, theater, and dance from a young age, while other students get very little. It's unfair and unacceptable that some students should not realize their full potential as artists, musicians, actors, dancers, and more broadly as creative thinkers and problem solvers because they didn't have the same opportunities as other students in neighboring districts. This past year, there's been a focus in the national conversation on equity, diversity, and inclusion, and ensuring that everyone's voices are heard and valued. In that spirit, we need to realize the mandate laid out in California Education Code, which states that all students, K through 12, will have access to the arts. Not some students and some of the arts, all students having access to art, music, theater, and dance. My request of everyone watching is that you use whatever platform you may have to advocate for all students to have access to a robust and well-supported arts education. Talk to your school boards, talk to your legislators, and tell them that you want the arts to be as valued and as supported and as celebrated as other subjects. Thank you, and I hope that our 2021 Stand Up for Arts Day will be meaningful and inspiring to you.
Hello, My name is Nikayla Irvin. This is a collection of quotes from art students at CKM McClatchy High School in Sacramento, California. Art means that I can depict even the most abstract of feelings and my own personal experiences in a way that's comfortable and effective. It means creativity. Art exercises my brain. There's something so therapeutic about art. It can express so many emotions and convey so many different experiences. It transcends language and cultural differences. Art gives me the opportunity to express myself. It's how I make myself be heard. It's a way of expressing yourself so unapologetically, because art's just a bunch of people who have things to say and an endless way of saying them. There's something so magical about being able to create a world of my own from my imagination and bringing it to ours. Art is an escape. Art means that I can express myself in a way that makes me feel safe. I enjoy working with others to evaluate our work. Art doesn't have to have an intended meaning in order to speak to others. It's about putting everything in your mind visually and having it look better than what you imagined. Art makes me feel good about myself. Art's a way for me to speak without ever having to actually speak. Through art, I can objectively tell that I'm growing as a person with more complex thoughts and feelings. There's so much freedom that comes with visual art, and anybody can make it. Art speaks for the era for it was created. Visual art is a way for you to be who you really are, regardless of social standards. I use cartoons to help me explore different topics and illustrations as well. To me, art means survival. Art is infinite to me, as there's always new pieces to be created. Visual art is a way to represent yourself. Art is relieving my head from chaos and sharing my thoughts with the world. Art is expressing the most deepest, different parts of myself. By sharing your view, you can connect with someone on an unspoken level and potentially change lives. Art is everything in life. Visual art to me is manifesting feelings, thoughts, and colors that swirl inside of us on a physical, shareable canvas.
Hello, everyone. Welcome. I'm here to greet you on behalf of the Executive and Greater Board of California Dance Education Association. Thank you for making it a priority to be here today as part of the Stand Up for Arts Education Advocacy Day. We are so grateful for your time and commitment. The timing of this event aligns with the National Dance Education Organization's intention to honor March as Dance in Our Schools Month. We are grateful to be represented here today alongside our four arts ed orgs partners, including California Music Education Association, California Educational Theater Association, and California Art Education Association.
As we reflect upon this unprecedented and unique time in our history, the importance of arts education cannot be overstated. Providing equitable access to arts education is critical to ensure social-emotional learning outcomes such as self-knowledge, self-expression, and caring for others. The arts teach children to embrace their humanity. This self-awareness is invaluable in creating a world that honors kindness, inclusion, and community. CDEA wants to say a huge thank you to all of the dance educators who have adapted to our new reality and strive every day to bring positive, quality educational experiences to your classrooms. We also say thank you to students of all ages who have adapted alongside your teachers.
Lastly, thank you for making it a priority to participate in today's Stand Up for Arts Education event. You're helping us advocate with our California legislators about the importance of equitable arts education for all children. So go forth, send our powerful message forward about how the arts change lives. Thank you.
My name is Faith Lopez. I am a senior at A.B. Miller High School, and I have been dancing for 4 years. My dance journey started my freshman year of high school when in middle school was offered to me as a substitute for P.E. dance. I joined P.E. dance as a sort of way to get out of regular P.E. However, just for my first year of dancing, I learned so many new things about myself. One of the many things I learned about myself in P.E. dance was how productive I could be, and I never really tested that limit, especially my freshman year, until in dance we were given work to work on independently. Along with learning how productive I could be as a student, I also learned about my time management skills, and that was especially important so that way I could balance my home and school life. After taking my first year of dance my freshman year of high school, I decided that I really loved dancing, so I auditioned for the conservatory program, which I am currently in now. From here, I can honestly say that I've learned so much about myself physically and mentally, and especially mentally, because even though dance is a physical activity, it's so expressing, which I can honestly admit, and I'm sure others can as well. There's so much freedom in dance that you're not given in the real world or the school world, which I think is really necessary for students as it can act as a therapy, considering it's an emotional and physical relief. And at least for me, it's a way to break out of my comfort zone and present myself in a physical space instead of just always focusing on my grades and textbook work. Overall, I just want to say that none of these opportunities or lessons would have been learned if it wasn't for dance being offered to me in middle school and all throughout high school.
Art and theater mean expression to me.
Art to me is being able to share your voice and perspective with the world.
Art means creation and opportunity and living life to me.
It gives me a way to voice my opinions and call out injustice either against me or against other people in a way that I wouldn't be able to in words.
Art to me is a form of expression and communication. It allows people to convey themselves when they can other ways. Art is both a representation of progress and culture.
To me, dance means expressing yourself through movement. When you're happy or you're sad or you're lonely or you're nervous, you express those feelings through your dancing and people will see that.
Dance to me means being able to express yourself in any way, shape, or form and not feeling critiqued, judged, or embarrassed for your chosen way to express yourself.
Dance is very important to me because it has made me who I am today. It made me be more outgoing and to speak up more in life.
Dance means a lot of things to me. It's something I love, it's something I cherish, and it's something I want to pursue.
Dance shaped me into a form where I want to be a good kid. I want to always stay a good kid. That's where I want to be, is on a good path, having a good future. And dance has brought me every time to those realizations.
Theater is my best friend. Theater was there from beginning to end. Theater taught me things I didn't know I would need, things that would help me grow and succeed in the future.
Theater has helped me be a more sympathetic person by helping me see that there are many sides to a story and that you need to look at other people's perspectives always.
Theater is a necessity. It is healing. It is powerful. And it will outlast even the darkest of times.
As actors, we have a voice that can touch the hearts of our audience. So it's important to me that I use mine to advocate for those whose voices may fade into the background.
You grow so much by learning an instrument or singing, and it's just this fulfilling opportunity that you get that, I mean, sticks with you forever, and it's so great and so amazing, and I'm so lucky to have it in my life.
Hello, my name is Kaden, and violin is important to me because it helps me calm down when I'm stressed, and it is fun to explore all the sounds my violin can make.
One thing I love most about band is how we're all together and how we're playing together. Like, it's so fun to play by myself, and I love to do it, but it's even more special when I play in a group or in my band class.
It's important to learn music at a young age because it develops a love for music early, and for me, it's tapping into a way I can express myself. And I can't wait to head back into the classroom and start performing in choir again.
What I love about this music class is the community here, or the community in the band, is awesome. Everyone supports you. It's really fun. There's many activities you can do, and it just overall helps your how you think and how you see like the world.
Art provides a way for us to reflect on our emotions and better understand them. It is a form of expression that teaches us about ourselves and others, making us more considerate and intuitive individuals. Art requires us to dig deep, think harder, and reflect more honestly about the world and the role we play in our community.
Thank you for joining us today as we work together to advocate for our children's right to a quality education in the arts. We stand up today and every day to provide our children the opportunity they deserve and must have to experience the arts, to be educated in them, and to express themselves through the skills they learn. Now, more than ever, it is time to support arts education more strongly than ever. Thank you.